Nice tight receive here, left inside the table, low enough to make for a difficult flick.
Lovely soft hands. Great net awareness. Chen Chenyi.
Corner to corner here. Wang Manyu's going to be changing her tactics, I think, in terms of placement. But right now, normally, you'd see a lot more backhand to backhand sort of trying to pin the middle. That serve is quite interesting. It was like a bottle challenge, but shorter. Wang Manyu dealing with some heat coming in, but stays in control.
When you see two right-handed Chinese women up against each other, you see these backhand to backhand zipping exchanges, but this is going to be slightly different. Maybe more open rallies.
It's exactly as you said, right down the line, a beautiful parallel here to tie it up from Chen Tianyi.
It's just insane to think Wang Manyu has only ever lost to one left-handed player since she's represented Team China.
We have our guesses. A nice dodge here. Do you have that one?
I'll find it out for certain, but I'm guessing it's Ding Ning.
That's my guess. Ooh, edge of the table here for Chen Tianyi. So with the first towel break, in all fairness, I think the reason we both think that is when you think of the most powerful left-handed players, and we're not talking, I mean, there's Kasumi. You've got a handful, you've got Jun Jihe, you've got Hina Hayata, but on the Chinese team, how many major big players have there been heroes in the last 10 years outside of Ding Ning who were left-handed?
This is a thing, not many.
That parallel again to finish, but it's a lot of work. These open rallies are coming quickly.
They are. Wang Manyu's going to have to be wary about where she's putting that ball if she is going into the Chen Tianyi forehand. Right now, Chen is the highest ranked left-hander in the world.
I'm impressed right now because Chen Tianyi's backhand is quite crisp on the parallel and the forehands we've seen, but she looks so fluid and free, even more so than we've seen yet this event.
This is the thing. I'd use the word seamless to describe Chen Tianyi. You don't think of her as a huge hitter, but I think that's the way she moves.
Right. Three serving five, the favorite, down by two. No! This, the Great Wall of China here, just holds up a shield, blocks it right back. It's Yang Ziliu and her mom. Look at that. Hey, Australia in the house. Down under and down in the front row. Good time to have those privileged seats right now. A little bit off the top of the net, but again, she just has no hesitation in the game.
It goes to show as well, doesn't it? You don't need a massive stroke to create power. It's the racket speed that comes through the acceleration in the forearm and wrist. Efficiency.
For me, the transition, and I think that word seamless is a perfect way to describe it, but we saw the replay before this. Chen Tianyi had almost no backswing. I mean, she was right in front and still managed to guide the ball. She makes her middle nearly disappear, and for a tall player, it's quite impressive. I mean, her middle, it just reminds me, I don't know if you've heard this, but how come you never see elephants hiding behind dandelions?
That's the first time I've heard it, but I'd love to hear the analogy.
Because they're really good at it. Same idea here. Her middle's huge, but she hides it so well.
I see.
Beautiful backhand here for the third ball. Wang Manyu making her way back in.
And she could play that winner almost every time. It's just a case of how often she gets those kind of balls, and so far it's not been very often.
Hello, Ball Kid. Good to have you here. Some of our unsung heroes that add to the seamlessness of this event.
We're loving that word right now.
Seems as if we do. Good deception on the serve. I can't remember. It's been a while since I've seen Chen Tianyi, if at all, have trouble on the serve receive in such a way. Again, credit to Wang Manyu for digging deep, making that subtle contact. 2 points between them now. Clean right at the back of the table, just so keen to pick up any little bit of wiggle room there for the opening attack.
There's something intimidating yet gentle about the way she plays. The contact you can hear there, so much quality coming in.
That touch shot, she was up looking like she was about to attack and then just dropped it at the perfect length.
That was beautiful to watch. And the way she came up on the backhand, watch this, came across it. That's world-class hand skill.
And it sets up 4 game points. A player who's never taken a game against the world champion has 4 opportunities here. But this one's quick and untouchable. Wang Manyu sneaks past on the parallel. 3 game points left for Chen Tianyi on the receive right now.
Left, 7 turn.
A lot of work for a point, but you could hear that extra effort from both of them.
Yeah, for sure. Trying to transfer the weight. Wang Manyu, look how wide that base is to get the balance. Chen Tianyi's free arm and what she does with her hand really fascinates me. Have you seen the way she points her finger up, almost as though she's about to call a let?
Yeah, I've been distracted by that in the past. I think you just have to get used to it, like a natural motion that's part of somebody's game.
Yeah.
2 game points left, Chen Tianyi with the serve. And there it is, down the line, leans to play the forehand from the middle. Well, game two about to start, Chen Tianyi up 1-0. I'm curious, Fraser, do you expect to see more short play and touch play from Wang Manyu?
100%. And I think more towards the forehand, because we know that Chen Tianyi can flick with that backhand, even from the middle. So you've got to try and stop him from doing it. Wang Manyu's going to have a little bit more decisiveness with that touch play, I agree. But I think a parallel forehand has been a big difference maker so far.
And doing a good job of bringing Chen Tianyi in and then sending her back. Playing in combinations, forcing her to get a little bit less leg behind her shot. And an outright point on the shovel serve.
Yep, coming around the side just to make it less obvious what she's doing with it. Testing the forehand flick. Because if you push that, it's going to pop up, unless you really come around the side and trap the topspin, which is really difficult to do.
Wow, similar example. And in all fairness, it's played well to the baseline. But Wang Manyu, again, will not be bothered by this shot. Typically, I mean, she gets a good opening there. Usually she'll make that shot to continue the rally. Look at this, it comes in fast and it comes back even faster, the pace in this rally.
The anticipation, the way she reads this, only took such a short stroke as Wang Manyu really threw the kitchen sink out of there. And there's a lot of power coming in to shorten your stroke. Already pace on the ball.
Yeah, kitchen sinks are heavy.
Yeah, they certainly are, mate.
Ha, ha. Clever idea here, and a bit fired up. Wang Manyu, after losing her first game ever to Chen Tianyi, is going to be quite determined here in game number two, as we've seen. First towel break, and Wang Manyu up by two.
Notice Wang Manyu sort of stepped back a little bit more, just to give herself a little bit more time and space. That's how she can get her big strokes in.
Again, these are two of the tallest players on the Chinese women's team. Good placement again, that shorter forehand, that shovel serve, and you can see Chen Tianyi sort of going through her options there on the receive. But she's going to have to find some answers.
Yeah, for sure, because if it's not broken, don't fix it. We might see Wang Manyu continue to do this serve. Mm.
And so far, she's found a lot of success with it. As you said, it's just going to be a question of time before Chen Tianyi figures it out. But in the meantime, Wang Manyu is going to keep cashing it in. That she recovers as quickly as she does. Chen Tianyi, amazing. Plays some big forehands in this rally, and still Wang Manyu counters.
These are the kind of free-flowing rallies that can really inspire a player watching this.
That last shot there, she was completely set up for a forehand, and still, it's that very subtle, seamless transition, is able to play the backhand to recover. Good look at the wide corner here. I feel like a lot of left-handers who play the inside-out forehand commit to stepping around a deeper backhand and play a bit wider, but Wang Manyu doing a good job to keep it deep and spinny. Still, no answers found against this serve.
I feel like if someone plays it down the middle of the table, it's harder for you to create a wide angle from that. If you give someone a wide angle, it's easier for them to make a wide angle back.
Correct.
Hashtag truth.
Yes. Taking a risk here, trying to play it early off the bounce. It's funny, against lobs, a lot of people on the internet will say, oh, just take it right off the bounce. If you can, yeah. It's tough for the defender, but it's incredibly difficult for the attacker to do. The timing, 6 of the last 8 points to the world champion, Wang Manyu, and she's up now by 6, 2 points away from securing game number 2. Beautiful parallel backhand here.
Yep, testing the in and out game there. Good. Let's see this. Into middle, and then a bit wider. You see that tactic quite often.
Yeah, very perfectly executed here from Chen Tianyi. The touch play and a clean finishing backhand like we saw in game number 1. Game number 1 wasn't dominant. It felt like it was for some reason. Again, maybe the calm of Chen Tianyi. That is so smooth in a replay. Looks like an action film, the way she does that.
It's like throwing a frisbee.
An explosive frisbee to save a city. And a little fortune for Chen Tianyi. Wang Manyu taking a little walk here, almost as if she was contemplating a timeout. It is a best of 5.
Will we see the shovel serve to dig her out of trouble? I mean, she's in the lead, but you can feel the momentum switching slightly.
And it continues to work. The percentages on that serve are so high right now. And Wang Manyu, with the same score line that was imposed against her in game number 1, has 4 game points. That shovel serve trouble for Chen Tianyi right now. But the serve's back with Chen Tianyi. Following the net, saving game points.
Don't think Wang Manyu is too concerned right now. Even if Chen wins his point. Again, that serve has been so reliable that the top's been shovel.
And Wang Manyu closes the door on game number 2. We get into game number 3. Wang Manyu looking to pull ahead.
One love.
It's interesting when the players get really gritty and vocal in their teammates.
Yeah. No love lost. It's another day at work. It's not like they're playing the world team champs. They're playing for themselves and for potential Olympic and world championship spots.
That is just incredible. Behind the table, as smooth and slick as can be, she brushes the side of the ball with topspin as well. The confidence, the wingspan.
Out the middle there. Feeling is not always about shot blocks or around the net shots. There was a lot of feeling in that attack down the line. Understanding of the ball.
I feel like the variation that she brings, Chen Tianyi, reminds me a little bit of Wang Chunting's backhand. That it's just tough to rally with at times because she puts on different amounts of spin and different combinations quite frequently.
Yeah, it's a guessing game, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. I guess.
Left, 2-1.
Good touch there. So I think she knew Chen Tianyi wanted the flick. Just did it a little bit more into that forehand wide area to make it almost impossible to play the Chiquita. Shovel time.
Now this shovel serve came a little bit longer and Chen Tianyi was able to open with the flick. Comes around for the Chiquita, the banana flick, with that side and top spin to get into the rally, yet still, Wang Manyu controls the rest of the rally.
I noticed that Chen Tianyi adjusted her receive position as well, just to favor it a little bit more, the flick.
Well, it seemed that Wang Manyu noticed as well, so she serves it back to the backhand side to change things up, but to no avail here. Chen Tianyi with that finishing forehand.
Took it so in front of her there. Wow, that is poetic.
That backhand once again puts everything to rest. It is so quick. Again, you look at her and you don't think power. When you think of her game, you don't think power. Just consistency, but she's developing it under pressure against one of the most powerful in the world.
It's a kind of Lin Wenru-like style of play.
It's a very good observation. Quality of rally here again. Wang Manyu to cover the wide forehand, playing a little bit more centrally in this rally and favoring the backhand. But even on the forehand, not quite the twist that we're used to here from her. It's a little bit more reactive, shorter strokes.
She is, with her feet, one of the players, Wang Manyu, that plays it actually quite square to the table. Until she comes over a slower ball, and then that's when she demonstrates her power.
It feels a little bit more responsive here, Wang Manyu, that Chen Tianyi is the one who's taking the initiative. And when she goes for the shots, I guess that's part of the rally in general, that she's just playing every shot that she can with full intention to win it. That said, Wang Manyu escapes this point, brings it back within 2 points. most power on the forehand we've seen from Wang Manyu in quite some time. She really works hard to get this opportunity.
This is the difference between her and Sha Sha. Sha Sha will come in on her own terms and attack whenever it's attackable. Wang Manyu will feed off the pace of her opponent until she spots a side and then comes in.
The timeout now. Oh, what a save. Just gets the racket up and catches the edge here. Wang Manyu ties it up as a last resort here on the chase.
That is an incredible reaction there. The ball that you felt shouldn't have come back came back. I mean, the initial wide ball as well from Chen was just breathtaking.
So Wang Manyu with serious momentum here. And a chance to step ahead as she gets the serves back. She's been very effective. The shorter shovel serves. Ooh, comes back for an outright point on a pendulum. This, for me, could just be that sort of coffee bean to your fragrance sniffing. Just something to cleanse the palate and keep the receiver guessing. Resetting, if you will, whatever patterns seem to have already set themselves up. How can you not love it? The grunt after grunt got louder and louder and eventually came to a boiling Cho. I mean, the effort that she's putting in here, we don't know exactly what's been going on, but Wang Manyu has played the last 2 weeks nonstop some very tough matches.
Yep, nearly had one of the toughest losses of her life to Dina Meshref, who played beautifully well.
Oh, break off the net here as Wang Manyu continues her sixth point in a row. Tough day right now for Chen Tianyi, but it's not over.
Yeah, that net really threw a spanner in the works of her set piece.
And a gift, attempted long serve. They're risky, she had to take her chances and play bold. But with Wang Manyu on the other side, it's always that much more, I'd say, specific that the serve needs to be, and it's now 4 game points. Wang Manyu breaks on through, 2 games now on the scoreboard.
She's not trying to construct the point, she's just trying to finish it.
Yeah, I feel the same. Here we go, Chen Tianyi to start it off. First time we've seen a change of pace out here, Wang Manyu. Or at least something that appeared to be Wang Manyu intentionally slowing down the rally once it's already open in the topspin game.
You barely ever see Wang Manyu play the Chiquita. Usually she'll just play the flick. You can see the trend here, 12 of the last 16 to the world champ.
That forehand is not coming back. It is a one-way ticket to the VIP seats, courtesy of the pace that Wang Manyu puts on that last forehand.
She's going to leave no stone unturned here. These are the kind of shots in the women's game we didn't see until this new generation, it feels. I mean, not to say we haven't seen powerful players in the past, but I'm talking about on average now. I feel like the power we see women's players illustrate is a lot more than previous generations.
Yeah, I can definitely understand that. It does look that way right here and now as we watch these two battle it out. Quick off the bounce here, Chen Tianyi. Now, if you're newer to table tennis, in all fairness, the equipment has changed a little bit over the years.
Yeah.
The ball's gotten a little bit bigger and less spinny, which has required a little bit more strength and aggressive play near the table. Ooh, Chen Tianyi getting some fans behind her here. They want to see this go 5. And in all fairness, I think Wang Manyu would have every right to have all the fans in the world. She's humble, she's hardworking, she's kind, she's a very fair player. And just has such a diehard, never give up spirit. Chen Tianyi, though, coming up, I think has been developing a lot of fans around the world. A little bit of extra spin here for Chen Tianyi, making her campaign, her comeback, one point at a time. Again, that shovel serve just a little bit longer. It's still half long, but Chen Tianyi's found some answers in that backhand banana flick receive. Back to the pendulum, but the bending wrist from the backhand. Wang Manyu doing a good job to shut down the comeback.
This is the thing. I mean, Wang Manyu seems like she can play a lot of shots from different positions, as can Chen. But Chen's energy is so in front of her right now. And I feel like she has to try and reset her base so that she can be more comfortable playing from the back of the table.
Little help off the top of the net from Wang Manyu. I like that she apologized in English. It's pretty common, I guess. Chinese national team, all for the most part, studying English a bit, but still a little bit shy to bring it out in public, on live TV. Tough times, though. Chen Tianyi showing a bit more expression than usual in that moment. I feel like when you're Chen Tianyi in this moment, there's this extra pressure to make sure that you don't let that net affect you.
100%.
I mean, how much fortune has come against her? She needs it now. People can let things like this that are out of their control break them. But if it's out of your control, you can't afford to worry about it. Same here in table tennis, as always. I like this. I feel like the fight is just getting more turned up and dialed in now.
The short stroke of Chen Tianyi's backhand is brilliant, but it kind of relies in a sense on a lot of pace coming in. Stop. Could we see a bigger stroke earlier? Oh, shush, please, says the umpire to the crowd.
Whoa. Yeah, I was going to ask if you heard what it was. Fascinating. Let the players play. The evolution of the sport. Again, as more fans come in. I'd be curious what the service percentages here are. Players right now, Wang Manyu doing an excellent job. And look at this, 67%, two-thirds of her serves have won her the point. Or at least she's 1 point on her serve. Chen Tianyi barely more than half. I think it's credit to that shovel serve.
Yeah.
Smart. Nice.
5-8.
Tell me more.
No, I like it. It's an identical service motion. Kind of bottle challenge effect, but not right down the line. Not so much side, but the surprise factor is high.
Yeah, something to keep Wang Manyu pedaling back, not creeping in too early for anything over the table. Good speed check on the serve there.
9-5.
And now Wang Manyu just 2 points away from moving on to the semifinals. Good pressure, the placement. It's shorter to the forehand and deep to the backhand. Now 5 game points and match points for Wang Manyu. Just everywhere she needs to be in this point, Chen Tianyi.
I've loved seeing the careful curation of each stroke that she's put together, but Wang Manyu, like a praying mantis, just seems poised that little bit more.
praying mantis. I couldn't quite put my finger on it. Six serving 10, four match points left. And Wang Manyu has taken down Chen Tianyi, the world number six, the world champion, will continue on through, and her fans will be...